Broadcasting live from the Norman P. Murray Community Center in the heart of beautiful Mission Viejo, it's Breakfast with Gary and Kelly, featuring special guest Peter White.
Hi.
Welcome to...
Who did that?
My God, what was that? Welcome to Breakfast with Gary and Kelly, everybody. We're really, really glad you're here. Thanks for coming. The biggest, ladies and gentlemen, this is the biggest audience sign up in the nearly four full years that we've been doing
this.
And
how many do we have here?
14. It hasn't been a great 4 years. No, I'm kidding. That's not true at all.
We have 525.
About 540.
Look how long that goes down. All those people. Can you hear us, cowboy back there?
What are you doing, romper? That's enough.
Oh, yeah, look, they're waving.
That's enough.
I just want to make sure they can hear us.
Yeah, watch this. This is going to cause a stampede. Look at what I have right here.
Ooh.
Huh? Look at this. You can't get this. Remember the commercial with the Dolly Parton and Porter Wagoner? Porter, you can't buy them. Because this is not hitting the streets until Tuesday, the 7th, but we've got him here.
Yes.
And better,
we've
got him here. Please, ladies and gentlemen, Peter White.
Yay.
Thank you.
Critter.
All right, look, he's here.
Stick around, we got them all out right here on Breakfast with Gary and Kelly. We'll be right back.
You know, welcome back.
If this had been the 70s, that guy might have been a streaker.
Peter White is here. Welcome.
I always wanted to be on The Tonight Show.
Well, this is The Tonight Show.
Yeah, right.
I'm Ed McMahon.
Yeah. Ho! Exactly.
Ho!
The morning show. I like
exactly.
That.
I'm so glad you're here. Oh, I forgot something. Hold on. Oh. I'll be right back. You guys talk.
Okay.
Go ahead. You talk.
Remember the last time you were on our show?
Yes, that was a couple of years ago.
4 years ago. You were our guinea pig.
4 years ago?
4 years ago, sir.
I was the guinea pig.
You were the guinea pig.
I was the very first.
We did 90 minutes, and he just went off.
Hey!
Oh, my goodness.
We missed your birthday! Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
You're not going to like
me. Happy birthday, dear Peter. Happy birthday to you. Very nice.
Thank you very much.
We couldn't let it go out of gallant. You gotta
40,
open that.
Right?
You gotta open it up.
Okay.
40, right?
Yeah, because that's the new.
I won't tell you my age, but I can tell you that 60 is the new 58.
There you go. Outstanding.
Can you Outstanding. Get it in?
To the bar mitzvah boy.
The bar mitzvah boy.
It was on sale.
That says volumes.
Yeah,
right
it does. It really does. Here
you
go.
Thank
check
you.
It out.
Thank you.
Check it out.
Thank
you need you. To open that.
You're not Jewish, are you? Are you
no.
Jewish?
No.
Oh. I don't know. I'm trying to be politically correct. Like, okay.
Oh, look, it's the butt paste again.
Oh, you got that.
You never know when you need this.
Yeah, that's so. Right. Well, when you hit 60, it's the new 58, and so is that butt paste.
Thank you.
So there, we got that going for us.
And we got Kate, too.
Congratulations on this, man.
Maybe we should talk about music.
Yeah, I think we should. I think we should.
That is a really cool
Wait event. A minute, does that mean you don't like the butt paste?
Oh.
Carrie. Can I talk about that photo real
yeah,
quick?
I love that picture.
You look so happy. I mean, not that you don't look happy now, but that is such a really great picture. Who took that photo?
That was my good friend Laurie Stoll, who's taken most of my album covers since Promenade 1993.
Wow.
Where, we come back?
Where was that
20
taken?
Years.
Is that in the studio somewhere or a green screen?
This one?
Yeah.
This isn't a studio, somewhere in downtown LA.
Really? That's a great shot.
Nice red backdrop.
Yeah, appropriate.
It's a great
It's called
shot.
Smile.
Yes, you know, I've always wanted to catch myself smiling on an album cover. We never really achieved it. I thought if I called my album Smile, there's really no way I could avoid it. So there I am.
And how did
it's
you come up with
the perfect plan.
How did you come up with the name Smile?
Smile was a song that I wrote maybe 10, 12 years ago. And it had this nice little chorus that goes, I just love the way you do it. I just love the way you smile. And I thought, that's nice. But there's only one thing wrong with it. It's me singing.
You sang the chorus?
So I let the song lie for years. And then one day, I thought, you know, my friend Mindy Abear has a beautiful voice. And she would be great singing on this song. So I got her in the studio, and we finished the song just like that.
Outstanding.
And that became the title track to the album.
Yeah. Outstanding. Yeah. You've pulled in everybody. You've pulled in everybody. And why not, huh? Including, I'm glad to see, once again, Charlotte is on this.
My daughter.
Beautiful daughter, Charlotte, is once again.
My daughter's here today.
Yeah.
And my wife, Robin.
Yeah. Thanks for being here, you guys.
Yeah.
And Charlotte.
I didn't know. What is Charlotte doing on this?
Charlotte plays the violin beautifully.
Really?
I love to hear her play. And I said, come to the studio and I'll find a little part for you to play.
She plays the violin?
She plays
this
violin.
Is the second CD that she's done.
Yeah.
Yes. That's a hard instrument.
Yeah, when she was 10 years old when we recorded on the Good Day album, she recorded a little part on there. And then now on the Smile album, she plays on a track called Don Quixote, which, actually I'm going to play later, but Charlotte declined to bring her violin.
This happens.
Daddy, I'm going to get confused with the rhythm.
Did she consult with her agent before she gave you that answer?
And when is my payment?
Yeah. Right, very wise. She's seen the show, apparently. Can you believe how long you've been doing this? I mean, all of us. But I mean, seriously, it's remarkable.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm always wondering, why don't people ask me the real question? Why are you still here?
That was not the question.
I started exactly 40 years ago.
Isn't that something?
Playing music professionally.
And you were 4, right? You were 4 years old?
Yeah, right.
Right?
Exactly. As a child star.
But you know, it's funny because my first professional job was playing in a holiday resort. And I thought, this is great. I'm being paid more money than I was working in the factory. Because that's what I was doing. And I get to play music every night. But it wasn't the kind of music I really wanted to play. I remember we had to go and play Tie a Yellow Ribbon every night, which is a very nice song, but it's not exactly the kind of music. I wanted to play more like Led Zeppelin, you know.
But I don't think your crowd would have wanted that.
No.
Or the management.
No, they didn't. So there I was playing Tie a Yellow Ribbon. And I learned a lot of songs because we never had any rehearsal with that band. I just joined the band, start playing, you know, and I kind of learned on the spot.
Did you have any education in music?
My father taught me piano. I always had piano lessons.
Good.
That's the bass.
But he also gave me my guitar, my first guitar, but he just left me with the guitar. That's it. There was no lesson. I never had a lesson to this day.
But you did piano. Da,
da, da, da. Yeah, I had lessons on the piano, which really helped me, and I would advise any musician starting out to learn to play the piano.
Yeah, because you could probably play any instrument after learning
it.
It
gives
piano.
You a really good grounding, and most of the songs I write are on piano, actually.
Do you still think in terms of the piano when a new tune is running through your head?
Very often, yeah.
We have a piano here.
Oh, yeah, you know, Gary suggested I play the piano, which I don't usually do on stage.
Wouldn't that be fun to see, don't you think?
I'd love to see it. You ready?
Well, yeah. Tell us what you're going to...
There's a song that I wrote. You know, I told you about the holiday band, right?
Oh, yeah.
Within a year after I had that gig, I met Al Stewart. And I started touring with him, which was changed my life.
It's crazy because it just went...
Changed my life. Before I started playing with Al Stewart, I'd never stayed in a hotel room, and I'd never been on a commercial airline.
Welcome to the music industry.
And I'd only lived in a house for 3 months that actually had a telephone.
Oh, I remember you said that. Unbelievable.
So one day he heard me playing this little piano thing, and he said, we should write a song based upon that little piano riff.
Wow.
And I'm going to play it for you right now.
Oh, absolutely.
Thank you.
That might be my favorite version of Time Passages, just that stripped out, that's
was
spectacular.
Was the riff that he was, that first part, is that a riff, that diddly 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 diddly?
No, I added that for a dramatic effect.
Oh. I love that.
But if I ever re-record that song, I should.
You should do that. I love that little doodle.
I just, you know, just
that
you
was
know,
wonderful.
Needs
I'm
a little
so
lead
glad.
In, you know?
I'm so grateful that you did that. And it was one of those things that because you had posted the, a week or two ago the video on the Facebook of you guys at Royal Albert Hall.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, this will be fun to watch. And I'm like, where is he? There's that's not him on that guitar. That's not him on that. Oh wait, that's him sitting behind the piano. And it was like, who you know?
Because we did that show. Last year at the Royal Albert Hall, and I had intended to play guitar for the whole show, but Al reminded me that he had hired me as a piano player.
Yeah.
He says, you should play piano for the whole show, and I'll get some other guy to play, you know, or Tim Rennick, who played a lot of the lead guitar, electric guitar on the Year of the Cat album. He came back, and that was fantastic, you know, to see Tim. And a lot of the other guys who had played on the Year of the Cat album, do we have the...
Oh, yes.
It was right here.
Oh, they're right there behind,
The Year of the Cat album.
That's in a good shape.
And that's called a record, everybody. Isn't that a little better deal?
And this is a gatefold sleeve. It opens up, and there's my picture. I was 20, just turning 21, I think.
Love it.
No, I didn't smile in those days.
Wow. So we are... We want you to play more. We're gonna take a break and come back and have you strap that guitar on.
Okay.
And stick around here. Peter White on Breakfast with Gary and Kelly. Welcome back to Breakfast with Gary and Kelly. Peter White. Peter White is here. The new CD is here. Smile. We expect all of you. Here's the thing. For his birthday, why don't you all buy this and give it to him for his birthday? Huh? And?
Oh, this is Aisha Love, who's going to be playing piano with me in a couple of songs.
Aisha, thank you for being here, Aisha.
Yay.
Terrific.
Aisha has her own CD, which just came out, solo piano music. Beautiful music. Beautiful.
Outstanding. What are we going to hear? I hope some of the new
songs. We are going to play the slowest song and the fastest song.
Oh, good.
All right.
Actually, we're going to start with the fastest song.
All right, should we synchronize our watches?
And it's called the song I'm going to play first is called Don Quixote's Final Quest.
Ooh. Very nice.
And,
Peter West.
All right. Thank you.
That was actually a song I wrote with my good friend Freddie Revelle many years ago, and I tried to get Freddie to come into the studio to record it with me, and he was so busy on the road. He was on the road with Santana, he's been on the road with so many bands, and I ended up playing the piano myself. But that was before I met Aisha, who plays it much better than me. But I'm going to play now the quietest, the slowest song on the album. This is a song I wrote many, many years ago. I think when I first came to live in Los Angeles in 1978, and I was heavily influenced by Joe Sample and his bless his soul, you know. And so it's kind of timely for us to play it now. But Aisha is going to start the song, playing it on the piano exactly the way I wrote it, and then I'm going to join on the guitar. This song is called Awakening. Thank you. of love on the piano.
Aisha, thank you so much. Beautiful. Beautiful. Peter White, we're going to take a break and come back with some more. Stick around here at Breakfast with Gary and Kelly. Spectacular. Spectacular. That was excellent. That was really nice. Boy, tell us about Aisha. How did you stumble into her?
I met Aisha at a club where a lot of musicians hang out and play. It's called the Club Cordial.
Oh, sure.
Or Cafe Cordial.
Cafe Cordial.
Cafe Cordial in Sherman Oaks, California. And she says, hi, my name's Aisha, and I'm going to make a solo piano CD. And I said, great, and when you do, send it to me. And she did. And I listened to her. I thought, this is fantastic.
She's
I love the way she plays the piano. And I said, where do you live? She says, I'm living in Orange County. I said, well, come down to the Gary and Kelly.
Orange County.
Oh, I'm glad you did. I'm glad you did. She's terrific.
That first song that you played was really upbeat, really fast, really like danceable music.
And actually,
Freddie Ravel is just amazing, isn't he?
Those songs are actually the last two songs on the album. There's like eight songs before that.
Tell us about this thing. It's just great. I mean, I want to hear your side of this.
It's just a collection of songs that I kind of stockpiled over the years. There was a time in my life when I wrote a lot of music. And it was before Charlotte arrived, actually.
Oh, of course.
Because everything changes.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it does.
I wrote hundreds of songs, and I just kind of kept them in the what I call the vault. It's not really a vault. And every now and again, I listen to these songs. I said, these songs should be finished and put on a CD. So that's pretty much all these songs are. I got my good friends. Rick Braun is playing on here. Of course, I have to have
you
Rick.
You really do. You've got all kinds of...
I like the...
Huge Groove. You get the sweeter, soulful side of Huge Groove. Not the funky Huge Groove that you know and love. It's the romantic side of Huge is on here.
So did you name all these songs prior to when you wrote them, or did you come up with names?
I kind of named them as I went, because a lot of them had titles like...
4 o'clock in the morning?
6:28:09.
Catchy.
It's very catchy. Which is the day
really
I wrote.
Catchy.
Which is the day I wrote the song.
Yeah, right.
Which one was that?
I don't remember now, but
because I'd love to know about how you come up with some of these songs. Do you listen to the song and go, that would be.
I mean, it's funny. The last song I played called Awakening. I didn't have a title for that. I just called it Ballad in D Minor, which is funny because it's not in D Minor. But at some point, I changed the key to E Minor. And I was listening to it in the studio, and I heard that the way it starts, it sounds like a heartbeat to me. Boom, 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 boom. And I thought, wow, it sounds like someone awakening.
And who's Jordan?
Is this Jordan? Jordan, a friend of mine in England, his daughter was having a 21st birthday party. He was saying, it would be great if you could dedicate a song to her.
Aww.
So the song was actually originally, before it's called Awakening, it was called Jordan's Song.
Aww.
But I just thought Awakening was... A nice title, but I still wanted to acknowledge Jordan.
For your friend.
It is nice.
Yeah.
Look, you made the cover of this. Smooth Jazz News, you are.
Yes, fantastic, yeah.
It's outstanding.
And I'm also...
Exactly.
Nobody knows, I was also on the cover of Rolling Stone.
Well! Really? Wow!
Nicely done.
That was a birthday present from my good friend Eric and Carrie.
Oh, sweet.
Smooth Jazz
family.
That's
amazing. That's outstanding, Eric.
Talk about Don Quixote's Final Quest. You talked a little bit about it.
Well, that was a song I wrote with Freddie Ravel.
Right.
And once again, it sat in the vault for many years.
Uh-huh.
It was probably my tribute to classical gas. You could probably hear a little bit of that in there. And I also changed the key because it was too much like classical gas, so I changed the key.
I cannot underemphasize
how much that song, Classical Gas, affected me. I was, 14 or 15 when that song came out. And up to that point, I was listening to the Beatles and the Rolling Stones, and all of a sudden there's this beautiful acoustic guitar played finger style.
Yeah.
And all the strings are going at once, but they're creating this rhythm. And I thought, that is amazing. I want to learn how to play like that. And, and I did. And that's how I learned to... That's how I come to play like the way
really,
I do.
It's very largely because... And he's a comedy writer. He wrote for the Smothers Brothers.
That's true. He wrote that for the Smothers Brothers show.
Yeah.
And it's probably the biggest selling instrumental song of all time at this point.
Yeah, it may still be.
Yeah.
Yeah, crazy. Really interesting.
Head Over Heels.
Head Over Heels is a single, and it's a very joyful song.
Are you Head Over Heels?
And I just thought it sounded like
somebody
head over heels.
Yeah, I can't
doing
wait to
hear cartwheels or somersaults, and that's a song that Rick Braun plays on.
I love
that. Beautiful flugelhorn.
I'd like to talk a little bit about Joe Sample. Boy, you know, just everybody, so many people were touched by his music. It's just phenomenal.
Well, when he did his first solo album, and I think that was Rainbow Seeker.
Yeah.
And somebody gave me a copy of that. It was on an LP, Gary, and LPs in those days.
That is long playing album to just, you folks at home.
And, you know, believe it or not, I'd never really listened to jazz that much. But with Joe, the melodic content was so inspiring and so beautiful that I just fell in love with his music. And his follow-up album, that Carmel, I loved as well. And I got to play with Joe on the Smooth Jazz Cruise a couple of years back. I remember I'm backstage in the dressing room hanging out with David Sanborn and Joe Sample, and I cannot believe my luck. You know, I'm a poor boy from England hanging out with these, you know, jazz legends. And Joe is trying to teach David Sanborn to play a Beatles song.
Really?
Which was Get Back. And I'm listening, I'm thinking, I know this song like the back of my hand. Why don't... So I said, Joe, I'll get my guitar and I'll come back and I'll show you and David how to play this song. And he says, great. And so we did. And I even have a picture of us doing that. And he says, come up on stage and we'll all play it together. So we did. So that was my one time jamming with Joe Sample. We played the Beatles.
Sweet.
Phenomenal. Can you tell me about the Royal Albert Hall thing too with Al? I'm assuming that you had played there before, but that's got to be such a special place.
I did play there one time before with Al, but it wasn't with a full band. Mm. And I don't know that it was that good a show either, but we managed to put together a great show. In fact, we're doing it again next year.
Oh, are you really?
Yeah.
Wonderful.
We're going to play the entire Year of the Cat album with most of the people that played on the album back then.
Wow.
And we're also going to go back even further in time. There's an album Al made called Past, Present, and Future, which kind of put him on the map here in the USA. We're going to play that as well.
What does it mean to you to walk out on that stage? It's got to be just...
Well, my father took me there when I was a kid to watch Tchaikovsky Overture, symphony, and never thought that I would be on that stage. It's probably the most prestigious venue in the whole of England, and so it's awesome. Hmm. Did I say awesome?
You did.
Awesome.
You did.
Say totally awesome.
I've been living in California for too long.
Totally awesome.
Oh my God.
Like, oh my God, like, really?
The sandals, well, yeah, maybe that has something to do with it, too.
The sandals are not a fashion statement.
No.
It's just purely for comfort.
That's the signature, baby.
Thanks for inviting me on this show.
You're welcome.
Oh, are you kidding me?
Thanks.
You kidding me? This is so special.
And we have a worldwide audience, too.
I know, worldwide. We're on alerttheglobe.com, so say hello to all your fans around the world.
Yeah, they're getting,
Bernard Fowler, he's watching, and I have a lady from Spain, apparently, just wrote in and said she loves you.
There's a lady from Spain, she adores you.
Write a song about the lady in Spain.
That's funny, it reminds me of a story. I also play the accordion a little bit. And I did some shows with Freddie Rebell, and he grabbed my accordion and says, I'll show you how to play the accordion. And he started playing Lady from Spain.
Did he really?
I've never played. I grew up in England. We didn't know that song.
I find it hard to believe, but you're going to be doing the Christmas tour again because that means it's almost Christmas time again.
Yeah.
Ridiculous.
Yeah. Yes, Mindy Hebert, Rick Braun, and myself,
we've been
doing a Christmas tour for many, many years.
Yeah, you really
That's
have.
We'll
so
be playing
fun.
At the Huntington Beach Hyatt,
mm-hmm.
and also in
San Diego?
Yeah, San Diego, the Balboa Theater.
Cool. cool.
In San Diego.
Very nice.
Right around Christmas time, so look forward to that.
Well, I can't wait to listen to more of this. I really can't, and I really want to hear that Head Over Heels song. Are you going to be playing? I know you're going to be playing next, right? I mean, tonight, right? I think we got a couple more songs out of them, right?
Yeah, I'm going to go back. I'm going to play a couple more songs, but I'm going to go back in time a little bit.
Oh, you are? Okay. Well, I'll listen to this then.
You will listen to that.
I will.
Hopefully you'll like it.
I know I'll like it. I already liked the Don Quixote. I was dancing over there. And then I tried to slow dance to the Awakening. Mark Crimmon and I were doing a little slow dance, but it didn't work out.
That's the first time I played that song in front of an audience.
Really?
Is it really?
In fact, both of those songs, I've never played them in front of an audience. So.
Well, we're so glad you did today. It's such an honor.
We really are.
Yeah.
We really are.
It's such an honor. It really is.
You've been such a great supporter of this station, too, over the years in the Bash. And thanks.
Thank you for all of that.
Well, the Bash is, for us, it's so much fun because we get together and we're all hanging out backstage. And
it is fun.
The music on stage is incidental to us because we're all having this hang backstage. And, wow, I haven't seen you for years. And you. And
I tell you, to me, that the year that Joe Sample was there was phenomenal, phenomenal. Yeah. Well, here's the other thing, too. You've been a great supporter of our show. I mean, here's the thing. We're almost over with our fourth year of this thing. We had done one show, and we had Debbie Reynolds. It was like, oh, my God, this is great. And then we got done with that, and wow, that was we got to do it again. Now what do we do? And I, you know, here's what I did. I pick up the phone. I call you. I'll never forget the words. And I said, look, I don't know that we know what we're doing, but really, you
know,
here's
the
thing. If you can, I'll never forget it because I heard over the phone, you said, who's this? No, what you actually said was, anything for you, Gary.
Yeah, aww. That's how I feel about Gary.
Thank you. Oh, that's aww. So sweet. Well, back at you, man. Back at you. So, all right, now that we've mutually sucked up to each other, I think we should take a break and come back and put you to work.
Okay.
All right, should we do that?
Yeah.
All right? Stick around here. More with Peter White on Breakfast with Gary and Kelly. By the way, he's been resting his guitar in my guitar stand, so I'm presuming when I go home and grab my guitar. Oh no, that's not what I was gonna say. I was gonna sound like you, but that ain't gonna happen.
I like the blue lights on his guitar. Did you see this? Did you see that? And I thought when he played, the lights like went off and on and stuff.
Keep thinking, Kelly.
Yeah, right.
You know,
I like
that. I saw them flicker,
it lights up.
And I'm
he
like,
plays
wow,
and it lights up.
So
yeah.
Cool.
No, so
I remember seeing this.
I can see in the dark. That's what it is.
I remember seeing a Chevy Impala that had that on it. What are you gonna do for us, man?
Yes.
I'm gonna play the song I started the show was the very first song from my very first album.
Yes, it was.
I'm now going to play the very first song from my third album, Promenade.
Ah! Huh,
lovely.
Outstanding. Peter White.
Okay, right here. Thank you.
you so much, Lois.
Peter White, everybody.
Huh? How about
that?
I'm not sure.
Y'all got to go buy this thing. Smile. It's out Tuesday.
We have it here.
Being here. We'll be back next month with Brent Perukas. Thanks, Peter.
Thank you.
You know what? See you next time on Breakfast with Gary and Kelly.
One more.